wonderful friends. Welcome and thank you for coming on this. I mean, it's a horrible Thursday night. You're right to stay inside. Also, there's nothing to go to anyway. Thanks for coming to join Imperial Lates Online. And my name is Steve Cross. I'm going to be one of your two hosts. And I've got to mute that. That's part of the whole thing. And I'll be one of your two hosts for today. I'm the one who's here to tell you about how things are going to happen. So as you know, 1 week every month, the wonderful Imperial College public engagement team explore a different theme through these online public events. The quiz is the last bit and the best bit, because it's the bit that features me. And the theme of this week has been Healthcare Heroes. So we're going to be looking at your bodies in this today's quiz. Now, I'm going to be joined by an incredible co-host of today's quiz, Maeve O'Sullivan. Maeve is the quiz boss. I am the kind of the grease between the rounds, you could think of me as, but I'm the gravy around the nourishing, delicate lumps of round. But Maeve is she's the meat and the vegetables. If you eat meat, I don't eat meat, but she's the other vegetables if you don't eat meat. She is a quiz boss. So the first thing I'm going to ask the wonderful Maeve O'Sullivan to do, and when she appears, the important thing is that you clap and cheer wildly like this was a proper quiz that we were doing. And I know you're in your houses and you're thinking, well, if I clap and cheer too wildly, the neighbours will complain. But I don't care about your neighbours. And also, what I like is the idea that they're going to pick up a broom and start banging on the wall, like proper old-fashioned neighbour complaints. But I know that it's 2020. What they're going to do is they're going to say nasty things about you on the street WhatsApp group, aren't they? I don't know. I'm not allowed in my streets WhatsApp group. Apparently, professional comedians just make jokes all the time. Anyway, let's have a huge, massive round of applause and welcome onto your screens and into your homes the incredible Maeve O'Sullivan. See, look, I clap and cheer. How are you, Maeve?
Hi, I'm all right. Thanks, Steve, for that lovely intro.
How are things backstage while I did that little bit of nonsense?
Not bad. Just making sure that I've got everything ready to go.
It'll be perfect. I mean, you wrote the quiz. You must know it off by heart. So, Maeve, we've got some rules, haven't we, for the people that we're working with. Our main rule is please come and chat to me in the YouTube thread, because while Maeve's asking all the questions, I've got a bit of free time. So, like, we can just hang out in the YouTube thread. If you don't know the answers, just come and talk to me and we'll have great fun. Maeve, what are the other rules of tonight's quiz?
So you can chat as much as you like in the YouTube chat, but until we do the answers for the questions, please do not post the correct answers, because that just takes the fun out of it for everybody. So that's the only thing you can't post in the chat, apart from nothing super nasty or troll-like, because we will kick you out if that happens. So good vibes only, please. We're particularly looking for comments on embarrassingly wrong answers that you had, or if you have any interesting trivia about questions that we are asking. We have five rounds, just so you know. We've got sort of a general knowledge round, then we've got a round on fake science, then I've got a round on higher or lower, got a picture round, and then we finish with a speed round. So I think we need to share straight away the picture round sheet, which should be going somewhere into the chat.
Oh, this is exciting.
Yeah, so you can have a look at that.
Something technical to go wrong.
It should all run really smoothly. There'll be that link in there. It should take you to a PDF.
Oh, there we go.
Of a picture sheet. Is that working for you?
I'm going to go and look at this. I haven't seen this yet. I'm quite worried that this is making you look taller than me, which is upsetting me.
Oh, no. Sorry.
Oh, yeah. No, I can see what that is. No, I'm fine with it. You should just go with it. Anyway, yeah, no, that works. Hey, everybody, that works.
Yeah, very, very good. The other thing that might happen is everything might go wrong, in which case I will be showing a slide. That's if things technically go wrong. So all the internet shut down. Sorry, Steve. So let me get my lovely PowerPoint in here. So that's us, Steve, Steve Cross, Maeve O'Sullivan. And this is the slide. Huh? Oh, I'm sorry.
You're not a doctor.
I'm not. I'm the only one here.
Can't Imperial give you a doctorate just for being so good at this? Can't you be a doctor of quiz or something?
Maybe. So this is the slide that will show up if everything goes really wrong. And one final thing, you will be marking your own quizzes. So there's no real point in cheating because there is no prize. So give it a go. Don't cheat. You're right there, Steve.
I've got a bit of a cough, just so you know, people tuning in, it's not a persistent cough, because it turns out that although children are really bad at spreading COVID, they're amazing at spreading colds. And my kids went back to nursery, which means every parent has now got the cold that's doing the rounds. So apologies for the coughing. I've got some medicine here, which for legal reasons, I have to tell you, is just medicine. It's nothing else. It's just a purely medical solution that I'll be using to keep myself well as we go through this quiz. Only I use this microphone, so there won't be any transfer of virus that way.
Very good. So that picture round that I've sent you will become round four. So you've got three rounds to have a look at that. Chat amongst your friends. I don't know if we've got any teams out there who are teams of one. You're very brave, and we admire you. So we have, yes, you all got the picture round. And then I guess we can kick off if everyone is ready. If you have any problems, we've got some Imperial people in the background. So write in the chat and we'll try and sort that out for you.
Maeve, do you need me boxing style to just parade around in a skimpy outfit holding a big sign that says round one?
That would be perfect. Have you got that?
I have neither a sign nor a skimpy outfit. We should have thought of this earlier.
Very unprepared. Okay. Round one, everybody. So there's 10 questions in this one. Round one, which I like to call something for everybody. Question one, name the five senses. There's 1 point for this. And the five senses, I mean in the traditional sense. So no senses that were sort of discovered after the original five. There's 1 point for this. Question one, name the five senses. Question two, the senses can often betray us. One particular dress that caused uproar in February 2015 appeared to be a combination of either black and royal blue, or, so I'm looking for two colours. That was the other two colours that it appeared. You want the two more? So this is question two. I'm talking about that famous dress that people argued about what colour it was. That was in February 2015. So it appeared to either be a combination of black and royal blue, or what were the other two colours? You get 1 point for this.
And you don't get a point if you write or royal blue and black.
I've got a picture of this later, so we'll see if we think it's the same colour, Steve. Okay. Question three. What is the name of that poor man who gets poked and prodded in the once popular board game Operation? It's a little picture of him there for you. That's question three. What is the name of that poor man who gets poked and prodded in the once popular board game Operation? 1 point for this question.
That's a tough one. Mm. Tough. I mean, all the bits of his body were named wrong as well, weren't they?
Question four. What is the correct anatomical name for the funny bone? Do you know this, Steve?
I mean, I know the GCSE biology answer, but I'm worried that if I say it, you'll be like, well, that's what we teach people when they're younger. But when you're more advanced, Imperial College surgery, you learn that, in fact, it's the Abflusgastonicanex zumpfidukadai or something.
So that's question four. What is the correct anatomical name for the funny bone? Okie dokie. Question five. We've probably all seen a Snellen chart at some point in our lives, pictured here. But which of the 11 lines on this chart qualifies you as having 20/20 vision? So that is a Snellen chart that they use for the eye tests. The test doesn't work on your screen, Steve, because you have to be 20 feet away from it. Well, and it'll have to be some kind of particular dimension. So what I want to know is which of the 11 lines on this chart qualifies you as having 20/20 vision?
Last time I went to the optician didn't have this anymore. She had a screen and she pressed it and it generated these randomly so that you couldn't just learn the Snellen chart, that old classic for not having to wear glasses when you're a teenager. And she had it on really hard mode, so it would give me whole rows of just C, O and Q over and over and over again, really tiny. She's like, which letter? Can you read this? It's like, oh, come on. It was like T, S. No, too hard. Put some proper letters in there.
Okay, so that's question five, guys. 1 point for that. Question six. Which is the largest, strongest, and longest bone of the body?
Oh, bone, right, yeah. Sorry, no, not what I was thinking.
What were you thinking? Doesn't matter. Question six for 1 point. Which is the largest, strongest, and longest bone in the body?
Is this of a, this is of a human, isn't it?
Of a human, yeah, yes.
I'm oh, just yes. worried about a pedant being like, it's a blue whale's hip.
Yes, definitely a human, which I thought I made clear by the clip art skeleton I used at the beginning of the round. But maybe not.
Wonderful people. If you see me looking down, I'm not ignoring you. I'm chatting to you on the YouTube chat thread. In case you're like, what's on Steve's desk that he's so interested in? The answer is my keyboard. I can't touch type. I didn't do enough Mavis Beavis. What's it called? Mavis Beacon teaches typing. Didn't do enough.
Question seven. This is a true or false question. Question seven. True or false, you have more bones as a baby than you do as an adult?
This question assumes that you haven't lost an arm or anything in between, just to be clear.
Yes. If you were kept completely in a kind of incubator from any harm.
Yeah, I mean, if you took the average, because, you know, through our lives, people lose bits of themselves. I'm sure if you took the average number of bones in a human, it will be less than the number we're told is the number of bones in a human.
It's probably true.
I'm just trying to stay one step ahead of any pedants in the quiz. We'll be calling and looking for half points later. I'm just ruling out all the clever things they're going to try and write.
So yes, yeah, so I just need a true or false answer to this. You have more bones as a baby than you do as an adult. Is that true or false? Question eight. Which of these is the biggest hospital in the world? Is it A, St. George's Ooh. Hospital, London? Is it B, the Clinical Center of Serbia? Or is it C, Chang'an Memorial Hospital in Taiwan?
I'll be impressed if anyone knows this. I mean, you got a 1 in 3 shot.
You've exactly.
And you can either rule St. George's in or out. I don't know how big St. George's is, but if you've been there, just think about it and think, does this seem big for a hospital?
So the statistics I'm using to define biggest is capacity.
Yeah, it's not like when people talk about their football team being the biggest and you're like, well, you don't have the most fans or the most money. And they're like, no, I'm biggest in terms of reputation. For anyone interested, Newcastle United, not a big club.
So that's question eight. Which is the biggest hospital in the world? Is it A, St. George's Hospital, London? Is it B, the Clinical Center of Serbia? Or C, Chang'an Memorial Hospital in Taiwan? Okay, nearly getting to the end of the round now. Question nine. A glossectomy is the removal of all or part of which body part?
I heard glossectomy and I assume that was just applying powder in order to appear more matte.
Glossectomy.
Yeah, the removal of gloss, a glossectomy. And we've got a double question, double check on the hospital question. What do you mean by big, physical size or number of people?
I mean capacity for patients.
Capacity for patients, Janice. Capacity for patients.
So that would probably end up being the largest square footage.
Yeah, I mean, also it comes down to what the local rules are for how densely you can pack them in.
Mm.
It's just if you ask, like, you know, how many cucumbers fit in your fridge? If I liquefy them all and lie my fridge on the back, a lot more.
You've done this before, haven't you, Steve?
What, liquefied a cucumber? No. I have left a cucumber too long. I think that's why they come wrapped in plastic, because if you leave them 4 days too long in the fridge, what you pick up is still holding inside it what I assume is the nastiest smelling liquid the human race has ever discovered. And it's one of the rare times. I'm not going to open that and put that in my food waste bin, I'm afraid. That is all going straight in the normal bin, because I think just the damage I'll do to myself, it's not worth the food waste. This quiz takes twice as long with me talking over every question.
It really does. Question nine. A glossectomy is the removal of all or part of which body part? So 1 point for that. And your final question, question 10, another multiple choice one. Cotard syndrome is a psychological disorder in which people believe they are A, immortal, B, Jesus Christ, C, famous, or D, dead.
Isn't B also technically all of the above?
Well, it depends what you believe.
Okay.
Well, I suppose you just say, yeah, immortal. So. It's an interesting point. So question 10, final question of the round, 1 point for this. Cotard syndrome is a psychological disorder in which people believe they are A, immortal, B, Jesus Christ, C, famous, or D, dead.
I really hope it's not famous. Someone might diagnose me in the YouTube chat.
Okay, so that is the end of round one. We'll give you a couple of minutes to discuss with your team or discuss with yourself if you are a team of one. We'll give you maybe two.
Or Google if you're a cheat.
So we'll give you 2 minutes and then we will go through the answers while it's all still fresh.
I've got some exciting news. I've got a new microphone. Look, it's the microphone that they always have on posters for comedy gigs.
Oh, yeah.
If the people organizing the gig have no idea what a comedy gig is like, because these microphones are never used for comedy. But I got one because I thought this is my chance to use a microphone like this for comedy if I'm doing comedy at a desk. If you ever see that sort of poster on the window of a pub, just my advice to you as a comedian is just don't go there. Don't go to that comedy night. It's going to be terrible.
Why aren't they using that for the comedy nights? What's wrong with it?
Because it's fixed. Like when you've got a comedy night, you want to take the microphone off so you can wander around and chat to people and say things and move your body. And also you want to use your face to be interesting. So when it's a funny bit, you go in the hope that people will laugh. And when it's a sad bit, you go. So that people know it's a sad bit. But if you've covered half your face with a microphone, they can't see.
Oh, I see. And are you using that microphone right now? Is that what you're using?
Yeah, it's plugged in. That's why people are thinking, stop picking it up, Steve. It's going every time you pick it up.
Got it.
Should we tell these people the answers?
Yes. All right. Ready?
No, I want to know the answers, and otherwise I'll Google them, and that's cheating.
All right, everyone, prepare yourselves. We're going to the answers to round one. So question one, I asked you to name the five senses. There's only 1 point for this, but you do need all five. So they are sight, sound, smell, taste, and touch. Five senses.
Imperial College would like to remind you, it's now recognized there are many more than five senses. We didn't want them. We don't want like proprioception and things like that.
Yeah, it was really easy to Google that. I was like, oh no, I just wanted a really simple question to open the quiz with. Okay, question two. This famous dress was either a combination of black and royal blue or white and gold. So that's the picture of the dress.
How did anyone get white and gold from that?
What do you see on there?
It's black and blue. Like, to see white and gold, you'd have to assume that everybody's going around with a solid blue light that they're shining on things. Like, where is this strong blue light coming from, white and gold people?
I see white and gold.
How?
How do you not? That's really weird. I thought that's very, very clearly white and gold.
That's blue. Oh, I mean, dear. I'll give you like dark, dusky, browny, could be black or gold. Yeah. But blue is blue.
Wow. That's really strange. Anyway, it's a big phenomena that we're not going to get into. But that is the answer, white and gold.
You getting it wrong and a bunch of other people getting it wrong.
Okay, question three. What is the name of that poor man who gets poked and prodded in the once popular board game Operation? He is called Cavity Sam. Cavity Sam.
That's a horrible name. No wonder his Charlie horse is so inflamed.
Oh, someone said, look, see, someone agrees with me. White and gold, Steve. White and gold on Ian's screen. Thank you, Ian. Liz, the controversy. Okay. Question four, I asked, what is the correct anatomical name for a funny bone? The answer I'm looking for is the humerus. Humerus. Is that what you were thinking, Steve?
That's the GCSE answer, but I was worried there'd be some clever imperial QI like...
Not that I could find. Okay, question five. So on this Snellen chart, which of the 11 lines qualifies you as having 20/20 vision? So it is, in fact, the eighth line.
I mean,
so that one there. That means you've got 20/20 vision.
So just remember, everybody, Def Patek. Next time you're getting an eye test and it matters, just remember Def Patek. You could make a mnemonic for it. Diamonds effectively feel positive, or they extremely can't.
That's very good,
easy,
Steve.
Remember. Thanks.
Interesting bit of trivia that I found out while researching this is that if you can only read line one and only line one and no more, then you are actually legally blind.
Also, if you can't even read line one, you are as well.
Yes. Yeah. You would definitely be blind if you couldn't read anything.
But you don't have to get the lawyers involved then. You just know who you are.
Yes. Okay, question six. Which is the largest, strongest, and longest bone of the body? This is the femur, which is also so that's the thigh bone. I will accept femur or thigh bone. Either of those is fine. Question seven. So this was true or false. You have more bones as a baby than you do as an adult. This is in fact true. So as an adult, we have around 206 bones, but a newborn baby has around 300. It's because they're born with more flexible cartilage, which then harden and turn to bone, and some fuse together. So they end up with less than they started. So the answer to that is true.
I don't know if any of you have young babies, but this leads to the very scary thing where they have a hole in the middle of their skull where you can see them breathing. It's like the top of their head goes up and down. And it is the creepiest, most like, if you've seen Alien 4, it is that level of creepy. This thing with no hair that just has a thing in its head that goes poot, 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 poot. Whoa. I've only seen it on my kids. I'm not saying anyone else's kids look creepy. Mm-hmm. Just now.
Okay, question 8. What is the biggest hospital in the world? So I can tell you that the answer is C, Changgun Memorial Hospital in Taiwan.
Well played, Taiwan. Tough luck, Serbia. Take that, George's.
Their hospital has a capacity of 10,000 people, whereas the Clinical Center of Serbia has a capacity of 3,150, and it's actually the largest hospital in Europe, that one. And St. George's Hospital in London only has a capacity of 1,300. Very little.
Yeah, unless you liquefy them and tilt the hospital on its back.
That's true. Okay, question 9. A glossectomy is the removal of all or part of which body? Something we might have to do to you, Steve, if we don't get through the rounds fast enough. It is your tongue. So a glossectomy is the removal of all or part of your tongue. Blah. Gross. And finally, Cotard syndrome is a psychological disorder in which people believe they are dead. So it manifests itself when someone insists that they are, despite all outward appearances and medical opinions, dead. So add those up. Tell your teammates. I don't know if some of you are playing remotely with your friends and have a WhatsApp group. So you need to oil up that machine because you've got some interesting questions coming up. Steve, I think it's time you
Hello.
How about so, that?
Let's talk about the division of roles here. Maeve is a genius, so talks to you about real world things that are interesting and exciting. I am an idiot, and therefore I'm going to be talking to you about diseases that don't even exist. But I am going to be testing your knowledge of popular culture to make up for all the people who are like, I thought this quiz might be about fun things, but it's all been about science and medicine. Don't worry, now is your time to shine. So for each of these questions, I'm going to give you 3 made-up diseases and 3, you might call them cinematic universes or movie universes or comics universes from which they might come. And all you have to do is match the disease with the universe. And you get 1 point for each correct pairing that you make. We've got 4 sets of diseases and book/film/movie type universe things, extended universes, we could even call them. And you're going to have to work through 4 sets of 3. So let's start with the first one. Can I have the first set of 3, please? So this is the challenge. Here we go. We've got 3 diseases. The diseases are cutiepox. I just love saying cutiepox, electric flu, and head go boom boom itis. And I want you to match those. One of them is from Pokemon. One of them is from SpongeBob SquarePants. And one is from My Little Pony. So you've got a moment to match those up. I do. Now, which one of these do you think is going to get electric flu? Is it Pokemon? Is it? Is there an episode where SpongeBob had lightning coming out of his nose? Head go boom boom itis. Did My Little Pony's head pop? Who knows? You've just got to match these up. And you'll get a point for each pair you get right. The good news is if you get 2 pairs right, you get the 3rd pair right automatically. So extra point there. So we'll just give you a moment to put that together. Now, Maeve, which is your favorite show? Pokemon, SpongeBob SquarePants, or My Little Pony?
I I've never seen My Little Pony at all, ever.
What?
I wasn't that kind of kid. But me and my... one of my younger brothers loved SpongeBob SquarePants. We found that very, very silly. But Pokemon.
Well, plus, we got to do that. We got to do that SpongeBob SquarePants question all the way in quiz 1, didn't we? Because there is a krill in SpongeBob SquarePants. Anyone who's been following these quizzes, we went krill crazy in the first quiz.
There was a lot of stuff about krill in that one.
Yeah, people still keep saying krill to me when I see them. I don't see them in real life, don't worry. We just have Zoom meetings and they're just like, krill those things. Good. I think we've had long enough to match those three up, haven't we? We don't have them quite long enough to type Hebgo Boom Boomitis into a search engine. So let's move on to the next set of three. Yes. So the next set of three are, the diseases are, say the opposite of what you mean disease. That sounds terrible. TS19. That's nice and quick. See, speeding the quiz up. And Dave's syndrome. And you've got to tell me which of these diseases came from which of these TV shows or films. They are The Walking Dead, Ace Ventura, Pet Detective, or Black Books. You've got to try and think, oh, in Black Books, was there a book called TS19 that had a disease in? We don't know. So match up the diseases with the TV shows and films.
I think everyone's concentrating really hard because we haven't had any admissions of stupid answers from round one yet, which is interesting.
That was the nice thing about people submitting answers online, was that I could then mock all their bad answers. Mm. Makes me very sad I can't do it anymore. Ace Ventura, Pet Detective was a long time ago. This is quite a dig there, Maeve. Mind you, I suppose it was Black Books, but I feel it's like a bit more canonical. You don't get people reminiscing about how brilliant Ace Ventura, Pet Detective was. And how sad it was, the way everything's gone since. I think they've probably had long enough on this one, haven't they? Should we move on to question three?
Yeah.
Someone claiming they got 14 out of 10 in round one.
Someone can't have, you can't have got 14 points in round one. It was only 10 points to get.
Don't rise to it, Maeve. Don't let them get to you.
Okay.
Let's have question three, please. My boss. Right, here we go. Oh, these sound exciting. So remember, pair the fictional film with the disease. Your diseases to choose from are Chimera, or Chimera, as I thought it was pronounced for the first two decades of my life, Crippen virus, and McGregor's syndrome. And you've got to tell me one of those lives in Batman and Robin. I'm assuming that's the Batman and Robin, the Joel Schumacher. Late 90s Batman and Robin. One of them lives in I Am Legend, and one of them lives in Mission Impossible 2. But which is which? Did Batman and Robin ever contract Crippen virus, Chimera, or McGregor's syndrome? None of which sound anywhere near camp enough for that film, I'm going to be honest. How do they all fit together? What disease was it that led to everybody being a vampire apart from Will Smith? Or the other guy in Omega Man. I can't remember who it was. Omega Man's barely watchable, friends. Watch I Am Legend instead. I tried, but just, I'm sure it was a great film of its time. Watching it with modern eyes, you just sit there thinking, come on, get on with it. All right, so we've had a chance to pair all those up. There's a potential 12 points on offer in this round, which is not to be sniffed at. Let's move on to question four.
Okay.
It's your last chance here. Oof, there's some tough ones here. Right. So the diseases are rage, also known as human corticodeficiency virus, Methuselah syndrome, and Reaper. And did these come from 28 Days Later, Doomsday, whatever that is, and Blade Runner? Maeve, what's Doomsday?
It's a film.
No, you need more than that. Like 28 Days Later, I know that's that one where they're in London and all of the corner shops are really well stocked. So you can just break into any of them and there's loads of like Twixes and dime bars and things. Blade Runner, there are no corner shops. What's the state of the corner shops in Doomsday? That's what I need to know.
I think that it's normal and it's before things go wrong. Don't want to say too many words just in case I give away something.
As long as you don't say rage, human corticodeficiency virus, Methuselah syndrome, or Reaper, I think you're going to be all right.
Yes, I guess so. Yes. I mean, I'll be honest, I haven't seen the film. I haven't seen Doomsday.
This is the kind of deep research that lies behind the Imperial Lates quiz, friends. Have you seen 28
Days Later? I am not a scientist.
Have you seen 28 Days Later?
No, I don't like scary films.
Okay. I mean, it's got a young Ewan McGregor. Is it Ewan McGregor? No, your other one.
can't be Ewan McGregor because I really like him.
Who's your man? Can't remember. He's very attractive. There's a young him strolling around empty streets in London looking wistful and underfed. You might like it. I don't know. I mean, you've seen Blade Runner, though.
Cillian Murphy.
That's your man, Cillian Murphy. Sorry, I live with Irish people, so I've adopted the thing of when you don't know someone's name, you just say your man, and it's acceptable. Like, people don't go, oh, you forgot his name. They go, oh, yeah, your man, yeah. It's weird talking to them because it's all your man this and our lady that. Thanks. That's my joke about the Irish people. Cillian Murphy. Everyone's telling me it's Cillian Murphy now. Oh, it's time for some answers. Is it? Well, no, it's time for some chat. We just did the chat before the answers.
That is true. Let's give them 1 minute. All right, well, you got 1 minute. And while you are looking at your answers for that one, I'll just remind you that there's 1 point for each correct answer in round one. So a possible 10 points, because we will be asking you at the end for your score so that we can tally it all up and announce the winner. So just make sure that you're doing that. And then in this round, it'll be 1 point per each correct pairing. Just in case I didn't make that clear.
And listeners, if during all this you're thinking, Maeve O'Sullivan's voice is wonderful, why not go and download this week's The News Review podcast? That's R-E-V-U-E, that stars this very Maeve O'Sullivan alongside three other wonderful actors. And one of the bonuses is if you download it, you get a great big picture of Maeve's official acting headshot, where she looks very meaningful. So do go. That's news, spelt news, and then review, spelt R-E-V-U-E. See, I don't just advertise my stuff on these things, Maeve. I advertise your stuff as well.
You're very good. Okay, we're going to do some answers that we can crack on with this quiz. So
we're going to bosh through these answers because, you know, you just need to check a line. You're not checking anything more complicated than that. Let's fire some answers at these wonderful, wonderful people. Remember, you get a point for each pair that is correct. Question one. Let's do the jiggle. Go. Thank you. Cutiepox is from My Little Pony. It's a disease spread by magic where weird symbols start appearing on ponies' bums. True facts. Electric flu is from Pokemon. It's just flu, but like a bit more electric. So
electric flu is where Pikachu becomes overcharged and really powerful and can't control his electricity.
So he goes, Pikachu! A lot. And then the head go boom boomitis. Hard to work out what the symptoms are of that. Technically, head go boom boomitis would be a swelling of the head go boom boom. That's from SpongeBob SquarePants. So remember, you get 1 point for each pair that you got correct. If you got two right, you will have got three right. Amazing. Let's move on to question two.
Well, I just have a couple of pictures that I got a bit excited about. This is someone infected with
symbols on the bombs. Exactly. I knew that.
And also this is head go boom boom itis, which is where you get turned into a baby.
Well, it's totally named incorrectly then. It should be called baby disease.
But it's if you take any damage to the head, apparently. So that's that. And that's Squidward suffering from head go boom boomitis. Okay, next.
Right, let's work out these ones. Say the opposite of what you mean, disease. I thought that would definitely be The Walking Dead. That would fit in really well. No, it's from Ace Ventura, Pet Detective. The Walking Dead is a bit po-faced for something like that, isn't it? I'm just chopping 98 zombies' heads off with a sword. The Walking Dead is TS-19 because they've written chop, 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 chop so many times in the script. They can't be bothered to come up with an interesting name for anything. So it's just called TS-19. And Dave's syndrome, you remember, is in Black Books. If the temperature goes over whatever it is, 88 miles an hour and the clock, then they go, no. If the temperature goes over 88 degrees Fahrenheit, Manny loses control of himself, I think is the best way to describe it. Dave's syndrome. Bill Bailey now owns his own zoo. Fun fact. Let's move on to question three.
There you go.
It's amazing how much money you can make just with a hot water bottle over your bits and eat me written on your front. Let's pair the fictional disease with the film. Chimera disease comes from Mission Impossible 2. Not Mission Impossible 1, if you wrote that. Also, you couldn't write it. It was just about joining the two up. Gripping virus. Threatening, doesn't it? It's from I Am Legend. That's the vampire-y thing from I Am Legend, which means McGregor's syndrome has to have come from Batman and Robin. I don't remember what part it played in Batman and Robin. I only, like everybody else, remember the nipples on the costumes.
Well, I did my research on this one. McGregor's syndrome is a disease which fills up the lungs with fluid and makes it very hard to breathe. That's what it does.
Right. That's called pleurisy, isn't it? Just or COPD is another. Anyway, right. Questions. Some doctors can help me with that. Question four. Rage. We all remember Rage. 28 days later, Rage, isn't it? Yeah. Methuselah syndrome. That's got to be Blade Runner. It's got to be Blade Runner. Yeah, because they meet the guy with the robot toys who looks really old, but he's not that old. Which means Reaper, the one we've not heard of, has to be from Doomsday, the one we've not heard of. So 3 points if you got all of those right, which by which I mean if you got the first two right and then the last two had to be Reaper and Doomsday, whatever they are. Two random words connected up while we're all busy watching 28 Days Later and Blade Runner again. So there's a maximum of 12 points for that round. So if you've scored it for yourself and you got more than 12, you've done it wrong. And so, yeah, we're keen to find out how you're doing out of 22 so far. How are you doing? Reminder, there's no prize. There's no point cheating. Maeve, have you got some more questions for these lovely people?
Some more questions?
Yeah.
As in the next round of the quiz?
That's the one I was thinking of, yeah. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Those seem like the obvious questions to do. We could do some others, like we just ask them, how are you? And have you talked to your parents lately? Have you told anyone you love that you love them?
Do not forget.
You never know. You've got to live every day like there might not be any more. So tell people. Oh,
well done, Zoe Gardner. 10 out of 12. Nice. Well done. 7 out of 12.
What did you get wrong, Zoe? What did you get wrong? Don't worry, it'll appear in the chat later. You can't wait for Zoe's reply.
Oh, that's true.
There's a delay between the two. You crack on with round three, Maeve. You crack on with round three. I'll deal with chatting to this lot in the chat thread.
Okay. All right, everyone. Round three, which I have called Break a Leg or Break the Bank. So in this round, I need you to tell me which cost more. Was it a procedure performed in the USA in hospital, or is it the other thing that I specify? So disclosure here that it's very difficult to find the exact amount of procedures. So the amounts are either taken from the New York Presbyterian Standard Hospital Charges List 2020 or from comments made by US citizens. As an example of how difficult it is to find out prices of things in the American healthcare system, this is a list that they have on their website to help you find out how much stuff costs. It's not very helpful, but I have found some information. So I want to know which costs more. For question one, which costs more, a 4-mile ambulance ride in Ohio or a taxi from London to Edinburgh?
That's a great question. That's a great question, Maeve.
Thank you, Steve. That's question one. For 1 point, which
also
costs
it's more? It's pronounced Ohio. You're meant to go up in the middle.
Ohio.
I was once chatting up a woman from Ohio in a bar and she told me that. That's literally all I got from the conversation, was I can now say, Ohio.
Ohio. Yes. What costs more? A 4-mile ambulance ride in Ohio, Ohio, or a taxi from London to Edinburgh? Question two. Which costs more? Treatment for twisting your ankle in an American hospital or a luxury foot massage in London?
What does a luxury foot massage consist of as opposed to a normal one? Do they make you a cocktail at the same time?
Yeah, I think in these luxury places, yeah, they give you some champagne, lots of nice smells and incense and something. I don't know, I've never actually had one.
Oh dear, Imperial College, it's time to pay Maeve more, because she needs one of those luxury... I mean, any of you who know the Kensington area will know that Imperial is entirely surrounded by luxury foot massage emporiums.
I should have worked at Google. That's where they have all that stuff, isn't it?
Maeve got to visit one.
All right, question three. Which costs more? Is it breast implants in the USA or a new padded bra for every day of the year from M&S? That's question
three. Some of you are going, which M&S range, Maeve? Are we talking basics? So, are we talking...
Well, I'm talking about the standard padded bra from M&S.
Okay, I get it. You're standard, yeah, all right.
So I hope people have some bra wearers on their teams.
The St. Michael padded bra, yeah.
So that's which costs more? Question three, is it breast implants or a new padded bra for every day of the year from M&S? Question four, which costs more? Every additional 30 minutes spent in recovery in an American hospital or one night at the Ritz and a welcome bottle of champagne?
Do we need to specify what make of champagne?
So this is where you can book your putting on the Ritz package at the Ritz. Right. So they give you the welcome bottle as sort of in the package. So it's not that you purchase the champagne. Okay. You choose the welcome package.
I mean, putting on the Ritz sounds quite uncomfortable. It looks heavy from the outside. Do you have to put the whole thing on, or do you just put a bit of the Ritz on? Sorry, listeners. I did a pun there on Maeve, which was extremely unfair of me when she's trying to work. Imagine trying to work under these circumstances.
So that's question four. Which costs more? Is it every additional 30 minutes spent in recovery in a US hospital or one night at the Ritz with a welcome bottle of champagne? Question five. Which costs more? A pen to mark on skin before surgery or a temporary tattoo kit from ASOS for each of the Von Trapp children?
Do they use a new pen each time?
I think that's how it's set sanitary. Well, this is one of the things that was on the list of supplies from New York Presbyterians. This is an actual amount.
Amazing.
But I want to know which costs more. Does the pen to mark on your skin before surgery cost more? Or is it a temporary tattoo kit from ASOS for each of the Von Trapp children? To do some of the maths in this question, you're going to need to have seen The Sound of Music. Bit of a niche. Probably not expecting that in a science quiz, but that's just how I roll. Question six, which costs more? 8 months in hospital for a broken neck in the US or a luxury round-the-world cruise for you and 15 friends?
That's just the question. It's so good. So good. Which one would you rather do at the moment? Which one is less risky, breaking your neck or going on a luxury round the world cruise?
But which costs more?
Oh, and, yeah.
And actually, I can tell you the website where I looked at the cruises. It's from
my parents. Sorry, it's from where?
Silversea.com. It's like luxury round the world cruises. So you know that it's a real amount. Basically,
my parents tell me about cruises all the time, so I've heard all the names of the things, but I don't remember them.
Okay, and question seven, which costs more? Skin-to-skin contact with your baby after having a C-section or an annual subscription to Zoom Pro?
What?
So in America, if you have
the baby there to there. Like, I've seen it happen in real life. There to there.
So if you have had a baby by a C-section, you have to pay an amount or it gets added to your bill
there,
to be the baby to be given to you to have skin to skin contact.
But you're both there anyway. What else are you doing? Just there.
It's a very good point.
Sorry, like, admittedly, the only C-section I was in was very, very, very late at night and in a quite stressful environment. But anyway, right, sorry. My knowledge of C-sections is limited to one.
Okay, question eight. Which of these costs more? Is it one cotton ball at New York Presbyterian or 100 cotton balls from Boots? Bit of maths here, really. Think about cotton balls from Boots. Which costs more? This is question eight. One cotton ball at New York Presbyterian Hospital or 100 cotton balls from Boots, that high street store?
It's a difficult one. Because in my head, I'm like, one cotton ball costs the same as probably 98 cotton balls, but there's plus or minus five on the 98, so it could go either way. It's really difficult for me. Boots where? Is it an airport boots? Because they're more expensive.
Question nine. Which costs more? Room and board to be kept in isolation for one day in an American hospital or renting a castle in Devon for 2 weeks? That's question nine. Which costs more? Room and board to be kept in isolation for one day in an American hospital or renting a castle in Devon for 2 weeks?
Are these interchangeable currencies? Like, if you own a castle in Devon, can you lend it to a doctor in return for, you know, go and live in my castle for a year and I'll stay here 26 days?
I don't know. I wish I knew someone who owned a castle. I mean, this one's from Airbnb, but so still think it's out of my price range. And finally,
why not pay Maeve more? I hate to go back to this over and over again.
You're just my advocate, aren't you, Steve? Okay, finally, question 10, the big one. Which costs more, a heart transplant or a one-month subscription to Match.com for the population of Berwick-upon-Tweed? Which costs more?
Just... what a great question. We've had the question, what exchange rate are you using? The answer is the correct one. Whatever it is today is the exchange rate that Maeve's using.
On Google.
Yeah. The exchange rate, as it's known.
So that's question 10, the final question. What costs more, a heart transplant in America or a one-month subscription to Match.com for the population of Berwick-upon-Tweed?
Now, why are you picking on Berwick-upon-Tweed here specifically?
So I was looking for a particular village, town.
It's not that you've long like harboured bitterness against Berwick-upon-Tweed and now is the time.
Absolutely not. They just had the population that suited me for this question. Okay, I'll just give people a minute to go through that. And don't forget, after doing answers to this round, we'll be doing the answers for the picture round. You've had that, been hanging on to that for a while now.
What was the question for the picture round? What is this a picture of?
Oh, yeah. I didn't write that on, did I? So in the picture round, you've got pictures of four x-rays, and I want to know what is it inside of this person.
Yes.
You can vaguely identify what is inside them. And then the second part is a chilled out cool guy skeleton, and I want to know where those parts of the body are on that skeleton.
Yeah, what's there that shouldn't be there for the first four? And then can you remember GCSE biology? We'll give you a second to do both of these.
Absolutely. Have you got any mood music, Steve, while we're
Well, on my little, but I've got nothing you can use for copyright purposes, unfortunately. The copyright-free things I've got are like screaming noises. And this, if you do a really good joke. But you haven't yet, so I haven't used it. That was heartless, wasn't it, listeners? That was absolutely heartless.
Very.
How many of you have been to download the News Review podcast? That's R-E-V-U-E, the News Review, just this week.
Leave
Don't
the
bother with any of the others. Don't subscribe. You just want this one with Maeve on.
Oh my goodness. Actually, I'm very excited
by YouTube's recommended other videos on this video, by the way, which are a day in the life of a bioengineering student. That's quite nice.
Mm-hmm.
And what can you do with a physics degree?
That sounds Aldi, Avenue Q. There's a song. Have you seen Avenue Q, Steve? It's a
no.
Numbers is what do you do with a BA in English?
Well, you host quizzes for Imperial College online, don't you?
Hmm. What?
No. What do you do with a BA in English? Tell me.
I don't have a BA in English, but what can you do with a BA in English?
You qualified from the Central School of Speech and Drama.
You're such a stalker, Steve.
It said it on the News Review podcast thing. You're very serious and you don't do jokes. And you graduated from CSSD. I'm not a stalker. You're famous.
So not famous. All right, I think it's time to do some answers. And thank you, Liz Danner. The ex-American is loving this round. Explain some of the reasons I live in the UK. Very happy.
Easy availability of cotton balls. That's what we always know about Liz, isn't it? Always got like 1,000 boots cotton balls on her at all times. These are at home.
I haven't told you ever.
Sorry. You know how cheap these are at home.
All right, everybody. It is time to mark that round. There's 1 point for every correct answer. Da, 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 da. So you're breaking your leg or breaking the bank? I wanted to know which costs more, a 4-mile ambulance ride in Ohio or a taxi from London to Edinburgh. So 4-mile ambulance ride in Ohio, £933. Taxi from London to Edinburgh, £538. So the correct answer is your ambulance ride in Ohio is more expensive.
You're breaking a leg.
What are you doing? I was wondering where you went.
Break a leg or break the bank. That's one leg broken.
That's a broken. No, you've broken the bank because you. You know what? I didn't.
No, it's break the leg and break the bank or go to Britain.
And both. Okay, so there's 1 point for that. Question two, which costs more, treatment for twisting your ankle or a luxury foot massage in London? So twist your ankle, it's going to cost you about £386 and a luxury foot massage in London is only £175. So therefore we have...
Bargain.
Once again, the American procedure is more. 1 point for that.
It's quite cheap, the twisting your ankle, isn't it?
Compared to other things. So... which costs more, breast implants or a new padded bra for every day of the year from M&S? So, breast implants works out at nearly £5,000. And a new padded bra, it's £12 per bra, 365 days. You're looking at £4,380. So, it's just about breast implants.
Mm-hmm. They look like quite good value if that's the alternative. Mm. Assuming they last more than a year and a bit.
That's the dream. Okay, question four. I want to know which costs more, every additional 30 minutes spent in recovery in a hospital or one night at the Ritz with a welcome bottle of champagne. So every 30 minutes spent in recovery, £360. One night at the Ritz, £702. So actually, one night at the Ritz is more expensive.
How much is it without the champagne?
£20. Okay, so that one is the Ritz costs more. Question five, Which costs more, a pen to mark on skin before surgery or a temporary tattoo kit from ASOS for each of the Von Trapp children? So, costs £21.47 to get a pen that marks on you for surgery. Temporary tattoo kit is £6.50 from ASOS, multiplied by 7 Von Trapp children, so that's £45.50. So, that costs more. 1 point for that. Question 6, which costs more, 8 months in hospital for a broken neck or a luxury round the world cruise for you and 15 friends? So you're looking at about $1.2 million someone paid, so 929 grand. A luxury round the world cruise is about 51 grand per person. So for 15, for you and 15 mates, you're well under it. You could even take some more friends with you. So it costs more to spend 8 months in hospital for a broken neck. Question 7, which costs more, a skin-to-skin contact with your baby after having a C-section or an annual subscription to Zoom Pro? Costs you £31 to touch your baby on the skin after you've had the baby. But an annual subscription to Zoom Pro is £119.90. So that costs more than skin-to-skin contact. Thank goodness.
Lasts longer as well. Doesn't last longer than a baby, but it lasts longer than the first skin to skin.
Question 8, which costs more? You're all dying to know. One cotton ball at the New York Presbyterian or 100 cotton balls from Boots? So one cotton ball at New York Presbyterian is 89 pence. You can buy 100 cotton, well, you can buy a pack of 150 cotton balls from Boots at £1.20, which makes it 0.08 pence for one and 80 pence for 100. So one cotton ball at New York Presbyterian Hospital costs you 9 pence more than 100 cotton balls from Boots. Question 9, which costs more, room and board to be kept in isolation for 1 day or renting a castle in Devon for 2 weeks? So if you wandered into an American hospital and they needed to keep you in isolation for 1 day, it would cost you just over £9,000. But it would cost you more to rent a castle in Devon for 2 weeks. That you're looking at about 16 grand on that one. So renting a castle in Devon is more expensive, which is the way it should be, but it's quite a hefty fine. And finally, question 10, I wanted to know which was more expensive, a heart transplant or a 1 month subscription to match.com for the population of Berwick-upon-Tweed. It costs £128,898 for a heart transplant. A month subscription to match.com is about £9.99. The population of Berwick-upon-Tweed is around 12,000 people, so it's about 120 grand. So it's just over the top there. The heart transplant costs more. So everyone, you can tot up your points. That's 10 points up for grabs.
Can people find you on match.com, Maeve? Is that why you bring it up? Is it a subtle advert?
I am not on
match. You can hear more from Maeve on the News Review podcast this week. That's
like your whole
job. A weird spike in their listeners just this week. And they'll think, we better get that Maeve O'Sullivan back on. She's incredibly popular. Right. Have we all had a chance to have a go at the picture round? If you haven't had a chance to look at the picture round, scream stop in capital letters in the chat thread on YouTube. And then I will hold off for a second. Oh, I've got this, and that's exciting. Sorry, there's more settings. There's more settings to play with. If you scream stop, I'll stop. Otherwise, we're going to bang on and we're going to do the picture round answers.
Okay.
No one's doing stop. No one's doing stop. Right. Let's talk about four things that are where they shouldn't have been. Now, we've sourced these pictures. We're not sure how many of them are x-rays of things that people actually got up there and how many have been cleverly put together by Photoshop experts. When it reopens and we're allowed to do it, you should all go and visit the Bart's Pathology Museum, where they have a whole case just full of objects taken out of people's bums that shouldn't have been there. One man had a torch, a big metal solid torch up his bum, and he said that he'd been assaulted by some rough Irishman who'd put it there. It's just a what? Great story. Right, let's move. Right, here are the four things that are up people's, maybe up people's bums. X-ray one is Buzz Lightyear off of Toy Story, who has gone up upside down, which is a brave move for Buzz Lightyear. X-ray two, I thought metal octopus, but no, it's many pieces of cutlery. Those would have gone in this way. There's actually a quite a well-known psychological condition where people swallow. No, there is swallow cutlery. Number three is a hand grenade. Pin is still in. If you look carefully, pin is still in. That is a safe grenade. That person has just got it there in case they need it for something. They're like, hold on. Oh, wait, I just pulled the pin out. No, pull the whole thing out. Number four, I couldn't even see anything, but apparently there's a toothbrush in there.
So I've enlarged it for your...
I mean, that has not helped, I think, is the technical term, Maeve. It was a bit of... Like, they should have swallowed a nice big, like, electric sonic toothbrush with batteries in. That would have shown up much better. Let's work through the bits of the body. This is like playing Operation, but without the fun of the Charlie horse. It's the only one I remember. Let's do these. Number one is your metacarpal bones. That's your fingers. Carpals, metacarpals, phalanges. Those are all your finger bones. Number two, your thyroid glands in your neck. Number three, your deltoid muscles. They're in your shoulders. Anyone who works out will have worked out their delts at some point. I obviously haven't. I had no idea where they were. Four was your gallbladder, known mainly for getting stones in and passing them being one of the most painful things in the universe. Five is your spleen. No one knows what it does. And it's an important fact of medical science that we never find out what the spleen does. Because if we did, that would probably be the end of humanity. We do know what the spleen does. Process dead red blood cells or something. Six, patella is the kneecap. Oh, it's very easy to get confused with the capella, which is somewhere else on the body that I've forgotten. Seven is your metatarsals. Those are the things you break before the World Cup. If you are being hyped as a really great player, but you know secretly that you're not actually that good. You're just a shark trapped in the body of a school bully, and you don't want to be exposed on the international stage, so you break your metatarsals, Wayne Rooney. And those are all the answers to the picture round.
Yeah.
Do you give yourself a score? Let's find out how you did. I mean, some of the toothbrush was hard, I think. It looked like they'd swallowed a cloud.
But
sometimes you've got to separate the real quizzes from the people who are just here for a laugh. You know, there's people who come on this quiz who are professionals, where this is like, they don't get paid, so they're not professionals, but this is what they do. You know, they're like, I am the online Imperial Lates quiz champion and no one better mess with me. And I could see the toothbrush, even though you couldn't, Steve, because it wasn't there. There was no toothbrush.
Mate, I wonder, do you reckon there's a correlation between people who can see the toothbrush and believe that that dress is white and gold?
Yeah, people who are hallucinating. That's the link between the two. People who are just saying any old crap. Those are the people that saw both of those. Like, I've got a 5K monitor here, right? If I can't see it, it ain't there. It's not there. That was the end of round four. So give yourself scores. Put your scores in the thing. What's it called? The chat thread. Put your scores in the chat thread and we'll see them and we'll go, oh, that's good, or that's terrible. Don't take it to heart how badly you've done. It's not a reflection on you as a person.
The other thing that you need to do is we're going to be sending you a link to a Google form. So what's going to happen there is you've got somewhere to put your scores for rounds 1 to 4. Put your team name in the box at the top so you know who you are. Yeah. And then you're going to go to the next page of that, which will take you to the speed round. So the questions aren't written on there, so you're not going to know what the questions are. I'm going to read the questions. But the speed round is a place where you can drum up a load of extra points very, very quickly, because it's 2 points per question. So we have some rules on the speed round. So every answer is worth 2 points. How many is round four out of? It's a good question. 11. It's out of 11. Jesse D. Round four is out of 11. So speed round. Every answer is worth 2 points.
Hi, Jesse D. I like your many excellent country and Western albums, probably, given that name.
Each question will only be read once. 10 seconds to submit your answers. The first team to submit their answers will get 2 bonus points. Second team to submit their answers will get 1 bonus point.
Oh, it is on. It's on.
Very, very on. There's going to be 10 questions.
Summer t-shirt.
You're going to, what? What are you doing?
I'm just wearing this to upset everyone who turned their heating on today.
Okay.
I turned my heating on, but I'm in my shed where there is no heating and I'm freezing. Mm-hmm. That's why I'm eating rainbow drops to keep me alive.
Okay,
right, so speed round.
Need to focus.
Focus.
This is the speed round. You must focus. You must listen. Are you ready?
I'll increase the emotional intensity.
Question one. Head, shoulders, knees, and toes. Eyes and ears and what? A, brow and nose. B, crown and nose. Or C, mouth and nose. Question two, statement. Someone who suffers from oniomania is obsessed with peeling onions. A, true. B, false. Or C, that's not a real word. Question three, what is the current cost of a single prescription? Is it A, £9.15? Is it B, £8.80? Or is it C, £7.85? Question four, what diagnostic tool for classifying the form of human feces is named after a British city? Is it A, Bristol? Is it B, Newcastle? Or is it C, Brighton? Question five. According to Britney, to lose all her senses would be just so typically what? A, stupid. B, lame. Or C, me. Question six. Which has the most bones? Is it A, the skull? B, one hand? Or C, 1 foot? Question seven. Were you listening in round one when I said the name of the chart that is used to test your eyesight? What is it called? Is it A, Skellen? Is it B, Snellen? Or is it C, McKellen? Question eight. The Scoville scale is a measurement of what? Is it A, saltiness? B, spiciness? Or C, sneakiness? Question nine. To the nearest degree centigrade, what is the average temperature of a healthy human? Is it A, 39.5 degrees? Is it B, 38 degrees? Or is it C, 37 degrees? And finally, question 10. What do antibiotics treat? Is it A, viral infections? B, bacterial infections? Or C, witches' curses? You now have 10 seconds. Okay, everybody.
How much trouble are you going to get in for putting witches' curses in there? There must be some pharmacology people at Imperial who are like, how could you even say the witches' curses don't even exist?
Yeah, you know, I'm a rogue agent. You know what I mean?
That's true. That's true.
That's okay,
very,
everyone.
Very true.
So while we get those answers in, it's going to be marked for you, and then we'll be able to show you the scores.
Like a real exam. It's being marked by university staff like a real exam. What an incredible quiz.
Like a real exam. Like being back at school. So let's go through the answers. Question one, head, shoulders, knees and toes, eyes and ears and mouth and nose. 2 points for that. Question two, statement. Someone who suffers from oniomania is obsessed with peeling onions. This is false. But not because it's not a thing, but because oniomania, possibly meant to be pronounced oniomania, is someone who is obsessed with shopping. They are addicted to shopping.
As soon as you put the accent on own there, I was really worried that was going to be worse than what it was. I'm quite glad it's shopping.
So CBD is compulsive buying disorder. If anyone wanted to know that.
And if any of you have that, my Amazon wish list is available.
Question three, what is the current cost of a single prescription? It is sadly the highest of those values, £9.15. Daylight robbery.
Prepayment certificates are very good value if you've got any chronic conditions.
Yes, it's a good shout there, Steve. Thanks. Question four, what diagnostic tool for classifying the form of human feces is named after a British city? Is Bristol, stool chart.
Where do you think of when you think of human feces? Bristol.
Bristol. Someone who I tested this quiz on said Newcastle. I was very offended by. That's where I'm from.
Rude. What's the Newcastle scale of?
It's nothing. It's just the name of a thing.
I just assumed it's like a scale of broken ankles from trying to get from the big market down to the quayside drunk.
It's the severity of stag do.
Yeah.
Question five. According to Brittany, to lose all her senses would be just so typically me. Oh, Brittany.
Is that a thing that happens to her a lot? She goes into like a sensory deprivation chamber, or is it medical? Or is it some kind of catatonic epilepsy? What?
No, she doesn't really specify. It could be that she just didn't understand her own sensory condition because she was quite young, I think.
Okay.
That makes sense. Question six, which has the most bones? So I can tell you that it is one hand. One hand has 27 bones. A foot has 26 bones. And a skull only has 22 bones. So hand. Question seven, were you listening in round one when I said the name of the chart that is used to test your eyesight? It is the Snellen chart. This is an action shot of Hans Mullmann doing his eye test to get his driver's license, but he can't see. Question eight, the Scoville scale is a measurement of what? Saltiness, spiciness, or sneakiness? It is spiciness. Looks a little bit like that. So I don't know. I'd love to know, people in the chat, if anyone knew what the Scoville scale was and has eaten anything on the upper half of that scale. So you can see jalapenos quite low down. And one of my best mates told me the other day that she tried something that I think was around the 300,000 Scoville heat unit mark, and said that it was just an insane experience. Question nine, to the nearest degree centigrade, what is the average temperature of a healthy human? It's 37 degrees. And finally, question 10, what do antibiotics treat? Viral infections, bacterial infections, or witches' curses? Bacterial infections is the correct answer.
What if the witch has cursed you with a bacterial infection?
The
witch is like, I give you chlamydia.
Oh, I see, like a witch's curse. I think it would depend, because maybe
probably needs some like lucky heather as well as some antibiotics to sort that out.
Yeah.
Something like that.
Yeah. I hope you're all on the edge of your seats because our team is getting ready in the background, just assigning the fastest team who get their two extra bonus points and for the second fastest team that get one extra bonus point. Okay, great. So I think
do
we're
you
ready.
Want me to read out the fastest team name that got that in there? Wait, no, they've said that's the winning team. Holly, is that name the winning team or the team that gets two extra points? Tell me behind the scenes what you can't see, listeners, is there's an incredible team of brains. Well, who did the fastest? Who did the fastest thing to get there? Ah, brilliant. Right. So the team that got their answers in fastest was the Fart team. Congratulations, Fart, which I imagine stood for something like Ferrari and Range Rover technicians. It's a team from one of the local racetracks who are looking after us. They got two extra points. Second fastest was the Branch Covidians. Very clever. Very, very clever name. Yes. Yes, they're all trapped in a compound together and we'll burn them out before everything is over. But the team that has got the most points overall, and I think Maeve is laughing too much for me to say it, is the absolutely wonderful Dildos. It might be pronounced Dildoffs. English is a very complicated language. It could be the Dildos, could be any of those. But I'm going to go with, there's a lot of like edgy team names in here. Hapless Hooters, dearie me. Congratulations, Dildos. You win nothing. One day, Imperial might put up one of those giant wooden lacquered boards with the gold lettering on to celebrate the team winners, and your name might go on there, but they might not. We're promising nothing at all. If you're a member of Dildos, do let us know in the live chat. Do some showing off. I think Zoe Gardner might be, given that. And let us know about anything else. Maeve, when can people hear another fantastic quiz from you?
Yes, I should tell people that, shouldn't I? Right, where's my information about stuff?
Well, Maeve's looking it up. You can find more of me by going to scienceshowoff.org. I'm doing loads of online shows like this, game shows, panel shows, comedy shows, quizzes, and some of them might have Maeve on if I can afford her. I know she costs £175 because she likes going at a luxury foot massage after each gig.
So if you enjoyed tonight, we have lots of other stuff that happened during the week as part of our Imperial Late series. So you can look it up if you go to if you just Google search Imperial Lates, or you can follow us on Twitter at Imperial Spark. We've just finished our Healthcare Heroes Lates. This is the final event. Thank you very much for coming. We do have another Lates coming up at the end of this month, because it is now just October, isn't it? It's like October just today. So our next Lates online.
Did anyone, yes? Who woke Green Day up? Did someone go and wake Green Day up? Don't they have that song, Wake Me Up When September Ends? It's finished. Who was in charge of that this year? Has someone gone and woke them up?
It wasn't me.
No, exactly.
So now that it is October, you can register for our next Imperial Lates online series, which is on well-being. We've got loads of really cool stuff that we're planning, and we're also going to be doing another quiz. So, you know, if you were just beaten by 1 point in this one, come back, try again. We'll have more interesting and fun things for you. And please do tell us what you thought of the event tonight. We're going to post a link into the YouTube chat. Your feedback really helps with stuff. We'd like to know how you feel. It's important to us, to me and Steve, and to the team at Imperial. So I guess that is, I think, all that I need to say. Is there anything else that you think I need to say, Steve?
I just wanted to congratulate all of our quizzes on a great performance tonight. I feel like we've all been on a journey together. We've learned a lot. We've been into the realms of science fiction. We've been deep in the human body. We found a Buzz Lightyear there. That was a bit inappropriate. But like, it's been a real emotional growth thing. I feel like all of us now, even though we weren't together, we are now one, all the quizzes together. And it's just, it makes me so happy to have done that. So thank you all for coming along. And thank you for all of the chat in the thread. I've thoroughly enjoyed telling you all you're wrong about the color of the dress. And do fill in our evaluation form and come back next month for some more silliness. And that's all you need to know. We're now going to have what we in the comedy industry call a break. This break will last for the rest of your lives. Enjoy it. Bye-bye.
See you later.